Good morning, students. Welcome to yet another class today on English language. Before we go into today's lesson, I must commend those of you girls who did quite well in your assignment under paraphrasing. It was a wonderful exercise, and I pray you keep it up. Alright, today we'll be looking at phrasal verb. I will have this object to the board. You should be able to define phrasal verb, to identify its types, to list at least 20 phrasal verbs, knowing their meanings, and then use them correctly in making sentences. What is a phrasal verb? A phrasal verb consists, number one, of a verb. It must start with a verb. Okay? A verb plus a preposition, or a verb plus an adverbial, or a preposition plus an adverbial, making up a phrasal verb. Remember, it must start with a verb. If you don't start with that, then you may confuse it with an idiom or something else. Okay, we have four types. We have the separable one, the inseparable one, the transitive, and the intransitive phrasal verb. What is the separable phrasal verb? It means that it can be separated. Okay, an example is they have called the meeting off. So the phrasal verb we have here is call off. Okay, call off. In the first sentence, you have call here and then off here. It means that you can separate this. Remember, depending on the usage. Depending on the usage. For here, I will tell you where you cannot separate at all. So you can separate this. Separate. Look at it here together. They have called off the meeting. They have called off the meeting. Inseparable. She backed away from the dog. The phrasal verb here is back away. Back away. Back away. Okay? And then we have she backed the... You cannot say she backed the dog away from. You cannot. Okay? So it is inseparable. Here it is. It is used together. She backed away from the dog. Here you can separate, here you cannot separate. It depends on your usage. Okay, we'll stop here because we are going to something for today's lesson. Okay, we have transitive phrasal verb. She gave up drinking 2 years ago. Transitive means that it acts on an object. For a verb to be transitive, it means it is acting on an object. If it does not act on an object, then it is intransitive. For that also, it depends on the context. It depends on the usage. And here we have a transitive one. She gave up drinking 2 years ago. She gave up drinking. Look at the object that was given up, okay? Gave up. So this phrasal verb is acting on this one. See the object. For that, it is transitive. For here, it is intransitive. I give up. Same phrasal verb, but here it is used in an interesting manner. Alright? Now, let's move downwards. Phrasal verb with two particles. This is the reason why we are here today. With two particles. It talks about a phrasal verb, a verb you combine with more than one particle. Okay? More than one preposition or more than one adverbial. A phrasal verb more often than not has a meaning that is different from the meaning of at least one of its two or three component words. The meaning of the phrasal verb, I said it before, is quite different most often. Those are the ones that are problematic. If you meet the ones that are closely related to what they are about, calm yourself lucky. If it's not, it becomes more interesting. I won't say calm yourself unlucky, but it becomes more interesting. So phrasal verbs have more than one particle. These verbs are usually transitive and cannot be separated. Now, this is what I'm talking about. These ones cannot be separated and they are always transitive. They act on an object. If you begin to look at the examples I'll be giving you on that here, you'll see that they are always acting on an object. Remember, they are always transitive and cannot be separated. Look at this. Look up to, which means admire. I look up to my mom. I look up to my mom. Who is the object I'm looking up to? My mom. You cannot separate them. You cannot say, I look up my mom too. You understand me? You can say I look up my mom to. Once you divide it, you separate it, it loses its meaning. It begins to mean something else that is not what you have in mind initially. Okay, you have get away with, which means escape the consequence. You can't get away with your action. What is the object? Your action. Okay? You can't get away with leaving things undone. Alright? So, you can't break it up. I've said it again. You can't break it up. If you keep on looking at example of an example, you discover that you cannot break it up. You have to join them together like that. Their meanings are derived when they are packed together the way they appear. Catch up with. Get up to date or meet up. I need to catch up with the assignments I couldn't do last week. I need to catch up with. Alright? It must act on something and it has to come together. If you say catch up, I need to catch up assignment with. No. It means something else. It's even ungrammatical. Okay? We have run out of. It means to use up or finish. Call upon. See someone or check someone. Remember, these are phrasal verbs that have more than one particle. What are particles? The addition to the verb. The verb and these are the additions. So we have one, two, one, two, one, two. Okay? More than one particle. Those ones you attach to the verb and the particles. Okay? If you look at this example in the book, they all have more than one particle. Two, precisely. We have barging on, which means to interrupt someone rudely. You barge in on a meeting. What did you barge in on? The meeting. The meeting is the object. Transitive. Barging on is acting on the meeting. Okay? We have stand up for, which means to be proud of or confident about something. To be proud of or confident about something. In such a way that you come out openly and say your mind about it. Everybody knows you stand up for the truth. Okay? They know where you are. If they want to get the truth, they come for you. If they want to get a fact, they come for you. Okay? Took off with. To leave with something in your possession. She took off with my handbag. The thief, the robber took off with his briefcase. Okay? Took off with. To leave with someone or someone's possession in your own possession. To leave someone's thing in your own possession. Okay. I'm sure you find this lesson very, very interesting because it's something you use every day. And I need to add this very, very quickly that a phrasal verb is used in an informal situation. Please note that. In an informal situation, using your informal writing to discuss with your peers, okay, your equals, and not with somebody who is in a high authority, or use it in a formal writing. Please note that, very, very important, okay? If you want your conversation to flow with your peers, the best thing to do is to go for your phrasal verb. So pick out terms in that verb on your own, use a dictionary. How do you get phrasal verb? You identify it with this, P-H-D-S. Is found in the dictionary. You can get a lot of them. Okay, using head word, you can use come, you can use go, look for, under come, you see a lot of them. Under go, you see a lot of them. Okay, keep on looking, you get more than 10, but I just want 10. It's just give me 10. 10, and you can get from 1,000. So give me 10, note their meaning. I don't want the meaning. Note them, it's good for you. All I want is to use them correctly to make 5 sentences. Remember, you write 10 phrasal verbs. Out of the 10 you write, give me 5 in sentence form. Okay, use only 5 out of the 10 you write to make sentences. Thank you so much for listening and have a nice day.